Hello friends, welcome back. Hearty welcome to you. Let's look at second order derivatives. So we know how to find out the derivative of a function with respect to x. Let's see how to find out the second order derivative. That's nothing but again finding the derivative of the first derivative. So how second order derivative is given by is y double dash or d square y by dx square, d square y by dx square or y2. Any one of the representation is fine. Let's take a simple example. Let us say we have a simple function y equal to 2x plus 3 divided by 4x plus 5. We have to find out its second derivative, or let us say y2 or y double dash. So first let's find out first derivative y dash or dy by dx equal to, we have u by v form here, so the formula is v square, that is 4x plus 5 whole square. Then I have v into u dash, that is 4x plus 5 into u dash is derivative of 2x plus 3, that is 2, minus u, that is 2x plus 3 into v dash, that is 4. If you simplify, we will have 8x plus 10, let me write it down here, 8x plus 10 minus 8x minus 12 divided by 4x plus 5 whole square. 8x cancels, we are left out with minus 2 by 4x plus 5 whole square. Now we have to find out second order derivative. So we will write down y double dash equal to dy dx of, what is our dy by dx? Dy by dx is minus of, shall I say, 2 by 4x plus 5 whole square, or can I say minus 2 into dy dx of 1 by 4x plus 5 whole square, so which is equal to minus 2 into, so at high level we see something like 1 by x square, that is x power minus 2, whose derivative is equal to minus 2 x to the power of minus 3. Can I write it as minus 2 into minus 2 into x to the power of minus 3, that is 1 by 4x plus 5 whole cube into derivative of 4x plus 5, that's equal to 4. So when you simplify, you will get 16 by 4x plus 5 whole cube. So to find out the second order derivative, first you have to find out dy by dx, then again you have to differentiate it one more time with respect to x. Let's look at some more examples. We have to find the derivative of second order derivative of e power 6 into cos 3x. So first let's find out what is y1. y1 or dy by dx equal to d by dx of e power 6x into cos 3x. So we have uv here. So u into v dash, what is the formula? Uv whole dash equal to u into v dash plus v into u dash. So d by dx of e power 6x into cos 3x is e power 6x into derivative of cos 3x, that is minus 3 sin 3x plus cos 3x multiplied with derivative of e power 6x, that is 6 e power 6x. So which is nothing but equal to, if I take 3 e power 6x common, I will have minus sin 3x plus 2 cos 3x. If I take 3 e power 6 common, I will have minus sin 3x plus 2, 3 is gone, so 2 is left out, and e power 6x is gone, so you have 2 cos 3x. Now y2 is equal to d by dx of y2 equal to, so we have, we'll take out 3 out, will have d by dx of e power 6x multiplied with 2 cos 3x minus sin 3x. So we have to find out the derivative of, which is equal to, let me keep 3 out, we'll find out the differentiation of that. This is u and this is v. We have to apply uv formula now. So let me write it down. 3 into, first I take u into v dash, so it will become e power 6x into derivative of 2 cos 3x is minus 6 sin 3x, because cos 3x derivative is minus 3 sin 3x, 2 into minus 3 is minus 6, plus, or shall I say minus, sin 3x derivative is 3 cos 3x. That I have to add to uv dash plus v into u dash, that is v is 2 cos 3x minus sin 3x multiplied with derivative of e power 6x, which is 6 into e power 6x. So if I take e power 6x out, I will have 3 e power 6x multiplied with minus 6 sin 3x minus 3 cos 3x plus 12 cos 3x minus 6 sin 3x. I can take one more, I will simplify that. It will become 3 e power 6x into minus 6 minus 6 is minus 12 sin 3x. Minus 3 cos 3x plus 12 cos 3x is plus 9 cos 3x. I can take 3 out from this. It will become 9 e power 6x multiplied with 3 cos 3x minus 4 sin 3x. So like this we can do so many examples. Only the thing we have to understand is, first we have to find out y1, then we have to find out y2. Let's do one more example. Find the second order derivative y2 of x cube log x. Again we are into uv form. So first let's find out y1. Y1 equal to x cube into d by dx of log x, that is 1 by x, plus log x into derivative of x cube, that is 3x square, which is nothing but equal to x square plus 3x square into log of x, which is equal to x square into 1 plus 3 log x. Now what is y2? Y2 equal to derivative of y1. So can I say d of y1 by d of x, which is equal to, let us say now that x square is u and this whole thing is v, we have to apply uv dash formula. So it will become u into v dash, that is x square into derivative of 3 log x is 3 by x plus 1 plus 3 log x multiplied with derivative of x square, that is 2x. If you simplify, you will have 3x plus 2x 5x plus 6x log x, which you can write it as x into 5 plus 6 log x. So let's do one more example. We have been given y equal to 5 cos x minus 3 sin x. We have to prove that d square y by dx square plus y equal to 0. So for that let's go ahead and first do y1. Y1 is derivative of 5 cos x, that is minus 5 sin x, minus derivative of 3 sin x is 3 cos x. Let's do y2 now. Y2 equal to minus 5 into derivative of sin x, that is minus 5 cos x, minus 3 into derivative of cos x, which is minus sin x, so it will become plus 3 sin x, which is equal to minus of 5 cos x minus 3 sin x, which is equal to minus of y. Therefore, y2 plus y is equal to 0. So in the next session, we'll solve a little bit intermediate level problems related to second order derivatives. We have looked into very simple examples in this, just to understand what is how to find out the d square y by dx square. Very simple. First we'll find out dy by dx, then we will take it as something like equal to y, and we again derivate that with respect to x. So I'll catch you again in the next session, where we'll continue with the second order derivatives and we will do much more examples. Thanks for your time and support. Bye for now.